Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video, we will learn how to download and install the current MongoDB version on Windows 11. With that, we will also create a sample database after installing. Let's start. Go to the browser. On Google, type MongoDB and press enter. Now click on the official website mongodb.com. Now after reaching the website, go to products, click the products menu. Now different products are visible. These are all MongoDB products. We want the open source version, so I'll click on community edition. Now here it is, go below. It's written download community, I'll click on it. Go below, here is the community edition. Okay, here is the version 8.0.0, MongoDB 8. It's for Windows x64 and the MSI package installer. Click download. I clicked on it. 713 MB. Let's wait. Guys, we have downloaded the installer file. Right click and click open. Minimize. Now the installation started. Click next. Here and select the license agreement, click next. Now choose the setup type, complete or custom. I'll go for complete directly. Now server configuration, keep it as it is, install MongoDB as a service, run service as network service user. The service name is MongoDB. This is the data directory. The following is the log. You should know this directory for any errors. So logs are really important. Click next. MongoDB Compass. MongoDB Compass is like a UI to work with MongoDB. I don't want to install it. So I'll uncheck this and click next. Click install. Installation is complete, click finish. Now go to the path, C drive, we installed it in program files. Okay, here it is, double click, click server, 8.0, bin, right click and copy this. We have copied this path, minimize, go to start, type environment variables. Here and click on edit the system environment variables, click open. Under advanced, click environment variables. Now go to system variables, path, double click, click new, right click and paste the same path, MongoDB server bin, click OK, OK and the last OK. Okay, now we need to also install MongoDB shell. That is MongoSH. Why? Because it is used for interacting with MongoDB deployments. So what I'll do, I'll go to the browser again, new tab, here in type MongoDB shell and press enter. Click here, it will directly take you to downloads, MongoDB shell, here it is. Here is the current version for Windows x64 10 plus, means it will work for Windows 11 as well. Package, I'll go for MSI and click download. This will be an installer file. Here it is downloading, only 45 MB. Downloaded, right click, click open to begin the installation. Minimize. The setup started, click next. Here and it will install MongoSH in the following location. I want for all the users of this system, so I'll just select this. So it will get installed in program files, MongoSH folder. Click next, click install. Now the installation started and it's complete. Click finish. Now we have completely installed it, but we need to verify also. Go to start, type cmd, click open. type the command mongod space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. This shows that we successfully installed MongoDB 8. The version is visible. Okay. Now minimize and let us start MongoDB. Go to start, type cmd, click open. Now herein type mongo sh, that means to start with mongo shell. Here it is, it started. Okay, the version is visible and shell version is also visible. Now let us see the default databases. Type the command show dbs and press enter. Here are the default databases. Okay, if you want to directly switch on to a database, type use command space, let's say our database is AmitDB, and press enter. So we have switched. Now within this we can create collections. Okay, let's create, let's say I'll create a new collection using the command db.create collection, and within that mention the name of the collection. Let's say I'll mention students and I'll just press enter. Okay, means we successfully created it. Now if you want a completely free MongoDB tutorial, refer the link in the description of this video. In that we will create a collection, then we will create documents and work around those documents. We will perform all possible operations on our collections and documents. Thank you for watching the video.